Such a big sook, aren't you? You want all the time to get up here with me. Hello, everybody. It is John and the producer, who's not too sure what he's doing. Currently got my phone on a stick, so the video wobbles a little bit. Oh, dear. It's somebody's kicking me out of his way. Come on, sit down. Come on. He's not happy. I've had to change some lounge couches around because my wife has decided she wants a change of the furniture. But anyway, what is today's video about? Yes, I'm talking about why audiobooks are one of my favourite tools for distraction against particularly my problems with mental health. And why are they? Well, for starters, they're a great way to educate yourself. I know a lot of people seem to listen to podcasts and that. I don't have a lot of time for podcasts. But I, well, actually, no, I take that back. There was a very good one released on Audible called Moriarty. And that is an absolute brilliant, a brilliant one where Moriarty is actually a good guy. And shall we say that Sherlock Holmes is an absolute prick. But generally, I don't have a lot of time for podcasts because they're just too short and I need something that goes for a considerable period of time that that keep me occupied. I've been using audiobooks for, audiobooks for more than probably 20 years. In my early days, we would have to deal with them on, oh dear, my camera's going everywhere because I can't sit still. Look, we had to buy them in these, and I must admit, these cost quite a pretty penny in the day. So, you know, I got the Lord of the Rings, I got the Silmarillion, I've got the Hobbit. So, you know, the standard Tolkien that everybody has to listen to. Then, of course, along came all the Harry Potter books. And, of course, with the Harry Potter, they also had the Audibles audios as well, and look, I've got them all. Stephen Fry would have to be one of my favourite voice actors or voice narrators. I suppose voice actor, but yeah, anyway, voice narrator is he does a brilliant job on this. Actually, there is a really good one also for he has also done Sherlock Holmes. And a number of others. So there were those. I used them mainly when I was in my active days of painting. I could do two things because I'd always be there going, look, I really want to read this book, but I want to paint. I got to create stuff. I want to do things, you know, or play a board game. Well, maybe not play a board game. That's multitasking to a totally different level than I can cope with. But I could paint, and I was painting vast quantities of miniatures back in the early 2000s, even before then. But it was, at that stage, I was, and still am, was severely suffering from mental illness. And I found that the only way that I could shut off my mind from ruminating on all the issues that affected me was an audible. Oh, sorry, it was an audio book. Sorry, yes, of course, Audible is, I guess, my main go-to these days for audios. But again, in the time, it was, you know, in the early days, you know, I'd have to go to, you know, I went to Games Workshop to get, you know, these little audio books. And of course, you know, they only go for something like maybe be lucky if they went for 30 minutes, I think, some of these. They weren't particularly long, but again, I was in the very infancy of audios going to, you know, Games Workshop putting most of their books to Audible and or audio. Look, let's just call it whatever. I'm getting sidetracked here. It is... It's really good because, you know, if I'm painting a 40k army and I'm listening to, say, well, they've only just released them now, is like Caiaphas Kane. You know, his books, you know, the Sandy Mitchell, I think it is, has written a bloody good series of, you know, a wonderful character. And of course, what also happened, you know, I love Torchwood. So I was able to, I found Torchwood. And of course, my good old Doctor Who, you know, really enjoyed the Doctor. Although, quite frankly, Tennant backwards has been my preferred Doctor Who. I'm sorry, I'm one of those people in the minority that I only believe the Doctor is male and he's essentially, shall I dare say, white. But that's just my preference, because all the Doctors that I grew up with, from the very first Doctor and from the original movie, you know, the, what was that one with Peter Cushing, I think was the, played the Doctor. And, you know, they have, for me, you know, that's my mindset. And I'm sorry if people are offended by that, but that's my opinion. Your opinion is just as valid as mine, as the way that you may like the way that the Doctor Who is going. But Audibles just make life so much easier for me, because one of the things that I do have is that I have difficulty sleeping, and consequently, rather than tossing and turning on my bed, ruminating about all the things that distress me and keep me, you know, a few sandwiches short of a picnic, the audiobooks just make life so much better. And because I can sit, I mean, I can lie in bed, I'm listening, my mind is off what's currently troubling me, and I'm listening to something that I enjoy. And a lot of cases I will keep, like, for instance, I really like the Terry Pratchett audiobooks, and mainly the ones that I think have been written by, well, the early ones, not the new releases that are coming out now. But I preferred, you know, Nigel Planner, and I think it was Stephen Briggs. Briggs? I can't remember now. But again, excellent. You know, the I know that they're trying to say, oh, these are poor recordings from years ago. But look, a lot of the stuff that I really want, you know, like, it's very hard to find Nero Wolfe as Audible. Although I found a new author called, I can't remember, I'll probably put a picture up here. There's, he's written, I think, about 16 books, taking on from Rex Stout. So, yeah. Look, I love audiobooks. I think that for me, particularly, look, to be honest, older I get, particularly, I guess, if I lose my eyesight, or my eyesight diminishes to the fact that I can't read books, I won't be happy. But at least, as long as I don't go deaf, at least I can listen to stories. So, look, this is why I really do think that people should embrace, you know, if you can't read, at least an audio will impart exactly the same information. You know, for people that, you know, have, you know, short attention spans, it, pardon me, it may be what they need. So anyway, look, thank you very much for watching this. The producer's gone off and had a sulk. Hopefully this video's not jumped around too much. Yes. So look, until next time, signing off, the Honourable John.